Hi everybody, thank you so much for tuning back in. I have had such a mixed bag of a week. You can say that the emotions were like a roller coaster a little bit. It kind of started off with driving my son to his first exam and then just getting into work and finding out that we have to get back to work 3 days out of the 5 days. After 2 years of being in the pandemic, it's a little bit of, for me, a little bit of a transition, I guess. I've enjoyed the chance to work from home and being able to get things done during the day while still hitting my work targets. So I guess, you know, building in time to travel to work 3 days a week is going to be a bit of a shift, but I will get there. Thank you so much. It's Saturday night and I'm heading out to a friend's birthday gathering at Donovan's, such a cute little spot in St Kilda. I've just been thinking about the kind of life phase that I'm now in. The Gen X is now, I guess, going through what they call the sandwich stage, where we have the duality of responsibilities of looking after our children, but also looking out for our parents as well. So it's been an interesting week because while I am getting my firstborn to his final year exams, I have also been checking in on my dad, who I think after his fourth COVID jab suddenly developed a really high fever and it kept peaking for a couple of days, which really scared all of us because he's such a fit man usually, and it's just really hard on my mum. But anyway, he's better now, which was such a relief, and you know, I'm just a little bit worried that my parents are aging, but that's another topic for the day. But first of all, let me tell you about this bread shop that I found recently. Amazing.
I've just discovered the best sourdough bread this side of town. It's from a bakery called Bromley, and there's a couple of them in Melbourne. And look how spongy it is. It has that sour, fresh sense to it. And I don't know, there's something about sourdough. It's healthy. Apparently you can keep it on your breadboard for like up to 3 days without it drying out, uncovered. Yeah. Oh, good.
Heading into Office Works to get some stationery with my son, and I spotted this technology bin situation that they have, which is very interesting because I've got lots of tech that I can definitely donate or bin at Office Works. Well done, you guys, for offering such a service. In the meantime, it's been raining.
Underneath the desk in grade 5. And we've been inseparable ever since. It's one of the greatest things.
And that was the voice of the amazing Chrissy Swan, who used to go to my high school. Chrissy, as you know, is now on The Project as well as many other programs on TV. And she does a wonderful job in emceeing this charity luncheon that I went to on this day. And here's Kate, founder of the Small Pleasure Fund. Is it really? And then I'm off to celebrate my niece's 3rd birthday. And look at this lovely, cute contraption. I really wanted one of those, a little mini sushi train. The theme was dinosaur, if you couldn't guess. Life, belief is not a dream, so dark as sages say. Oft a little morning rain foretells a pleasant day. Sometimes there are clouds of gloom, but there are transient all. If the shower will make the roses bloom, oh, why lament its fall? Rapidly, merrily, life's sunny hours flit by. Gratefully, cheerily, enjoy them as they fly. What though death at times step in and calls our best away? What though sorrow seems to win over hope a heavy sway? Yet hope again elastic springs, unconquered although she fell. Still buoyant are her golden wings, still strong to bear us well. Manfully, fearlessly, the day of trial bear, for gloriously, victoriously, can courage quell despair. And that was a poem by Charlotte Brontë called Life. Interesting that Charlotte Brontë, who's more well known for being a novelist, she wrote Jane Eyre, can actually pen such a lovely poem. Well, not surprisingly that it's a lovely poem, but that she actually even delved into poetry, really. But it is such a positive poem that I'm really glad that I found it through my quest to find a poem every week for my videos. So Charlotte is, of course, the sister of Emily Brontë, author of Wuthering Heights. And this wraps up my video for the week. Don't go away yet though, because I am going to leave you with a series of footages from a recent Hoodoo Gurus concert, which I went with some friends. It's Halloween here. And as we slide into another week, I wish you a very happy one. Have a really good rest if you need it. And go out there and enjoy your life, because life is short. Once again, thanks so much for joining me. And I look forward to seeing you next week. Take care. Bye for now.